All right, here we go. This will be our second problem, second example of finding the maximum flow in a network. We see here is our source node, here is our sink node, right here. And I've written on here the maximum capacities of the different links. So the first thing to do is to compute the residual network for this. And since all these things start off with, I initialize with everything with zero actual flow, the residual network looks just exactly like the original graph right here. So I need to find a path, an augmenting path from S to T. So let's go SABT just to get us started here. Okay, so that's our path. Okay, the bottleneck on that path right there. Well, I've got 3, 1, 2. So the bottleneck equals 1. So what I want to do then is push forward on all these links 1 unit. So let's go ahead and redraw our graph. And I will have here 1 unit out of 3 from S to A. From A to B, I will have 1 unit out of 1. And from B to T, 1 unit out of 2. And then the rest of my links are unchanged. So S to C, I have 0 out of 3. C to D, I have 0 out of 1. A to D, I have 0 out of 1. C to B, 0 out of 1. D to T, 0 out of 2. And C to E, 0 out of 1. And E to T, 0 out of 2. Okay, so this is our new graph right here. Let us compute the residual graph off of that one. So SACBDET, getting just a little cramped, but that's okay. So going forward, S to A, I have another 2 units that I can use to go forward, or I can undo that 1 unit. A to B, nothing to go forward, but I could undo the 1 unit that I had pushed forward there. B to T, I've got 1 unit left I can go forward with, and a backward undo of 1. A to D, I can push forward with 1. Let's see, S to C, I can push forward with 3. C to B, I can push forward with 1. C to D, I can push forward with 1. C to E, I can push forward with 1. And E to T, I can push forward with 2. Okay, so interestingly enough, our bottleneck was 1 before. So that's what I had right here, full capacity going that direction. That I can undo that right there. So now what I need to do here, oops, I forgot this D to T. Push forward with 2. Okay, now what I need to do here is find my augmenting path. So I could do S to A to D to T. S A D T. And the bottleneck for that is 2, 1, 2. So the bottleneck equals 1. So I'm going to mark here, but then I'll copy it onto a fresh page. So I want to add a forward push of 1 for each of these edges right here. So I'm going to make the changes right here, and then I'll copy it onto a new page. So I want to add a push of 1. That's my bottleneck. Add a push forward of 1. So this goes to 1 plus 1 is 2. And then A to D, I want that to have a push forward of 1. And then D to T, I want that to have a push forward of 1. So that is my new network right there. And now I'm going to copy that and put it on a clean page. Okay, so I have copied my new graph right here. So that's what I'm working with now. I need to compute my residual graph off of that one. Same nodes, S, A, B, T, C, D, and E. Okay. S can go to A with 1. I've got 1 left, or I could undo the 2. A could go to B, nothing, there's nothing left, but I could undo that one. B could go to T with one more unit, or I could undo one unit from T to B, backward edge, one unit. Okay, A could go to D, nothing, I've used up my capacity, but I could undo that of one unit. Let's see, D can go forward to T with one unit, or I could undo that with the backwards edge here in the residual graph of one unit. S can go forward to C with three units. C could push forward to B with one unit. C can push forward to D with one unit. C can push forward to E with one unit. And E can push forward to T with two units. Okay, so the next step is to find our residual graph right here. Let's see, S to A, oh, I'm stuck. There are only in edges on A. Okay, S to C, and then C to B to T. How's that? S to C to B to T. S, C, B, T. Okay, my bottleneck, I've got 3, 1, and 1, so the bottleneck equals 1. Okay, now once again, I'm going to, well, no, I guess I have room. I'm going to redraw my graph right here. So this will be the modified graph by using this augmenting path right here. So there's A, B, and T, C, D, and E, T, A goes to D, and C goes to B. Okay, and I think I've got to have the edges all going the same way because I'm looking at the actual graph, not this construct GR that I build to help me figure out what the flow on the actual graph will be. Actual graph. Okay, so here I've got S to A is unchanged, so that's pushing forward 2 out of 3. A to B is unchanged, so that's pushing forward 1 out of 1. Let's see, S to C is changed, my bottleneck is 1, so I'm pushing forward 1 out of 3 from S to C. C to B is changed, so I'm pushing forward bottleneck out of 1, so that's 1 out of 1. Okay, C to D is unchanged, so that's 0 out of 1. D to T is unchanged, because it's not in my augmenting path. This is my augmenting path right here. So D to T is unchanged, so that's my 1 out of 2. C to E, unchanged, so that's 0 out of 1. And E to T is unchanged, so that's 0 out of 2. And I have only left, let's see, I've got the S to C, that's my 1 out of 3. My C to B, that's my 1 out of 1. And then I have to add this one unit right here, bottleneck unit of 1, to this edge right here, so that becomes 2 out of 2. So the B to T edge is now full up. Okay, now I'm going to copy this graph right here. This is my current graph. I don't know that I'm done yet until I can no longer, I'll know I'm done when I can no longer find an augmenting path. So I don't yet know if I'm done. So I'm going to copy this and start it on a fresh sheet of paper. So here's my graph copied to a fresh sheet of paper. Let's compute the residual graph from this one right here. So S can go forward to A. I've got one unit left I can go forward, or I can undo 2. A to B, I've got nothing to go forward, but I can undo 1. B to T, nothing forward, but I could undo 2. Whoops, I forgot to copy what down what that was. I better pause and go back and look and see what that was. Okay, I went back and looked to see what that edge A to D was, so I'm good now. Okay, so A to D, nothing to go forward, but I can push back 1. Okay, D to T, I can go forward with 1, because I've got one more capacity available, or I can push back the 1 that I assigned right there. Okay, S to C, I can push forward two. I've got two left I can go forward with, or I could undo this one right here. So that's backward edge one. C to B, I can't go forward at all with that, but I can undo one. C to D, I could push forward with one. C to E, I can push forward with one. And E to T, I can push forward with two. And I hope that's it. Okay, now let's look and see if we can find an augmenting path here. S to A, and I'm blocked. S to C, that's still good. C to D to T. Okay, so S to C to D to T. S, C, D, T. Okay, my bottleneck equals, well, I've got 2, 1, 1. My bottleneck is 1. All right, so that means my new graph, S, A, C, B, D, E, T. And I could just draw all the directions of the edges that are right up there because the directions have to be the same. The only thing I'm modifying are the actual flows. Okay, so S to A is unchanged, so that's 2 out of 3. A to B is unchanged, 1 out of 1. B to C is unchanged, so that's 2 out of 2. Okay, A to D is unchanged, so that's 1 out of 1. All right, it's unchanged. S to C, I move forward, I want to push forward another 1 out of my bottleneck. So add 1 to this right here, so that gives me 2 out of 3. Okay, so that's on my path. Okay, C to D, I want to push forward with that 1, so that becomes 1 out of 1 is used. 1 out of 1 is used there. Okay, and C to E, nothing is used there, so that's still 0 out of 1 for C to E. Okay, D to T, I'm pushing forward with 1. That's my bottleneck is 1, so I'm pushing forward. It's on my augmenting path. This one right here has nothing to do with, well, it has little to do with what I'm modifying my capacities right here. This one right here went into computing the bottleneck. Once I know the bottleneck, then I use the bottleneck to modify the actual flow here. So this D to T becomes 2 out of 2. And then the E to T unchanged, so that's 0 out of 2. And I think I have everything covered there, so that's my new graph right there. All right, now I'm not sure I'm done yet, so let me copy this and start a new page.